Boom 103.9. You never know who's going to stop by that Kicks USA studio. Live hand clap for Fat Joe and Dre in the building.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
What's going on, my brothers?
We out here trying to survive. You know what I'm saying? We dropped a new single, Pick It Up. Me and Dre off this album called Family Ties. Me and Dre did an album together. You know, so excited, went top five in America.
Whoa.
So, you know, we was like, yo, we might as well just keep it going.
Keep it going. Yep. Let me tell y'all the feedback. Last night, I was in the strip club.
That's right.
And I dropped the Pick It Up. And it gave me the reaction that y'all brothers was looking for.
Oh, man.
I'm letting you know that. When I dropped it, because I introduced it, like, look, brand new Fat Joe featuring Dre. We call this one Pick It Up. I want you to do what the records say. Pick the money up. And it, you know, the guys let it rain. And it was a good record, man.
Man, that's great to hear, man.
Yeah.
We did it for them.
Now, Dre, did you produce this?
Yeah, well, you know, me and Kool cooked it up, but we got to definitely shout out Daz Dillinger. Because we really kept it true to the original.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? He checked in with us today, too, showing love.
Shout out Daz Dillinger, man.
Definitely.
And, but yeah, man, you know, I was watching a movie at the crib, the Tupac movie, and the scene where Daz was playing for him, it was fast, and then Pac said, slow it down, and I was just like, man, it's crazy. I ran to the studio real quick, sang the hook, called Crack Up. I was like, yo, I think we might have another one. I sang the hook for him. And out of nowhere, he's like, have Trump over the phone. I'm like, oh, man, we got one.
It was dope. Organic, just like that, Joe?
Yeah.
Organic, man, that's how we work, man. You know, this whole album, you know, we brothers, we've been working together 15 years.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's just so natural for us, man. You know, I always want to see him win. He always want to see me win.
Yeah.
Same thing with Remy and Khaled. We always want to see them win. And, you know, that's what it is, man. We just, you know.
I definitely like seeing the relationships that you have with each other still tight after all these years. You know, a lot of people fall out or whatever, but it's still cool. Dre, Khaled, Remy, you know, the TS is still out there. You know what I mean?
It's still... we out there fighting, man. We out there working, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, doing what we love to do. We blessed that God put us in a position to do what we love to do. You know, Dre been in the background writing hits for Khaled, writing hits for me forever.
Right.
And finally, I convinced him to come out in the forefront and, you know, show the people his talents.
Definitely.
You know what I'm saying? And I'm just happy to have him next to me, ready to go.
So, Dre, so more rapping and singing and less producing?
That.
Or which way you going?
More producing, more everything.
More everything.
I think that's what's great about the climate right now of music, period. I feel as though the people are very, very open and accepting of artists that have the ability to do it all.
Definitely.
You know what I'm saying? And
gotta be ambidextrous out here,
yeah,
man.
You know, and God's blessed me.
What?
You know what I'm saying? God's blessed me to be able to make beats and to write and to sing and to rap. You know what I'm saying? I'm 6'8", 220, so if we get it on the court, that could happen too.
Oh, you be balling heavy?
I mean, you know, we gotta do what we gotta do out here. You
know? Yeah, okay.
So, you know, we blessed, man.
We definitely blessed. So when is the tentative date for this album?
Man, it's spring, man.
No, springtime, right before the weather.
Oh, so now y'all want to start playing throwbacks.
Listen, real
let me tell you something. We've been playing throwbacks. Like this one right here.
So it's already finished.
Boom, 103.9.
Now, you got any special features on there?
Well, we got one right now, Bun B, legendary Bun B from Houston.
Heavy.
And, you know, working on one more, man. We ain't get it yet. So.
You ain't get it yet?
We gonna get it out.
That's good. Give me a little hint, though. Give me a little hint. Who it could be?
You know, we trying to get it.
He ain't trying to let it out. It's all good, though.
Sound like your drunk uncle.
Yeah.
What happened to the $10?
Yeah. Now, I recently read this quote about, you know, you saying that that little Uzi's like a.
Yeah.
A lesser version of Wayne? Is this true?
Nah, what I was saying was that Lil Wayne, I felt like Lil Wayne. First of all, I got mad love for Lil Uzi. I bought his album. I play his songs.
Okay.
Nothing but love and respect. You know how they try to sensationalize things and name it? It totally wasn't that.
Okay.
But what I was saying was that Lil Wayne influenced his style and a whole new genre of music. All these young boys... I heard Lil Wayne do all that, do all those flows. That's all I was saying. And then and it just got taken, you know.
Out of context.
Yeah.
Definitely taking out. You know how people like to take little pieces so they can make a little headline out of it.
They made a headline. Yeah. But, you know, I mean, hey, man, you know, all press is good press, you know?
Definitely.
But the fact that it, even in that interview, I said, naturally, you know what I'm saying? I got love for Lil Uzi. You know, I love his music, man. So, you know.
It wasn't what they said
it was.
It
wasn't what it's looking like.
Yeah. Definitely. Well, we are in Philly.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying? The Philadelphia Eagles are in the Super Bowl.
Nice.
Are y'all going for the Patriots or the Philadelphia Eagles?
You know, I ain't got a horse in this race. I'll let Dre answer.
I mean, I'm rooting for the Eagles. I'm a Giants fan.
Yeah.
So, you know, that means we automatic rivals. But, you know what I'm saying? You know, the Giants, we took care of Tom Brady both times and we had to deal with him. You feel me?
Yeah, you talking different. Real good out here, Dre. I see you.
I mean, we shine in them rings. But
yeah,
it's important. But I'm rocking with the Eagles. Fly, Eagles, fly. I'm hoping that front four and the D-line can handle their business. And, you know, the Eagles don't got to send a blitz. Because if the Eagles got a blitz to touch Tom Brady, it's going to be a long day.
Okay.
But, you know, I'm rooting for the Eagles. I was rooting for them when y'all had Terrell Owens and Donovan McNabb.
Okay, okay. Yeah, nice.
So, you know, I'm hoping they finish the job this time for sure. And shout out to the Sixers.
Woo.
Real exciting team, man. You know, y'all bringing
tough.
That, you know, I'm a Heat fan.
Yeah, Embiid.
You know. Embiid is a problem.
Oh, no, Embiid.
He's a Hall of Famer.
Hall of Famer already?
He's going to be a Hall of Famer.
Future Hall of Famer, for sure.
He stays healthy. He reminds me of Olajuwon, Patrick Ewing. He's a Hall of Famer.
Okay, I like the way you're saying that.
Nah.
You know, Rihanna wasn't trying to give him no play, though, fellas.
Now
he's a starter
that.
Now.
You got to earn
yeah,
that.
Yeah, he can't. You
got to earn
that's
that.
Rihanna.
He ain't earning by becoming a starter in the All-Star that she said. She said you got to be an All-Star. Now he's a starter.
You
got to drop them draws now. What you talking about?
Nah.
Come on.
She an icon. Hey, icons get to make the rules.
There's a pretty good way he could probably get a date with her. Drop the bag.
Nah, and then she's going to have to pick it up.
She gonna
have to pick it up.
He ain't talking loud enough. Yeah,
so what does he have
offers.
To do, in your opinion, to get her more of her attention?
I mean, somebody like that. What was his contract? Man, I think he got 100-something million. Man, little Rafe for him, little pink Rafe.
It's nothing.
So she could just ride to the date. He could do that for a little Riri plates and all that.
And then she gonna have to go pick it up.
She's going to have to pick it up. She might be so excited to go see him after that.
We two for two. Yeah. We two for two, right here, man.
That's right.
So anything else you want to tell the people?
Hey, man, look out for my sister's single, Melanin Magic. Number one most added, featuring Chris Brown, that Pretty Brown. We got music coming. DJ Khaled coming soon, too.
That's right.
Wow. I mean, Kent Jones, my little brother, he's on TRL today, 4 o'clock. He got a new song called Merengue. We just moving, man.
Moving, man. It's
shout out Meek Mill, the whole Dream Chaser crew.
Yes, man.
Talk
yes.
with us.
Yes.
You got any tracks with Meek Mill in the cut yet?
I actually don't. Know what I'm saying? But I know Meek since he started, man. I actually knew him before he started.
Right.
Coming out here all the time to see my brother E. Philly. You know, Meek used to be out here rapping and all that. But, you know, hold his head. He be home soon.
He be home real soon.
Right.
Big up to Fat Joe and Dre for stopping by the Afternoon Wave. Project is coming springtime-ish.
Just before summer.
Family Ties. Now, how many joints you got on there?
We got about 10 right now.
But 10 joints.
We can easily grow a little bit more.
Nice.
You know, as we keep making more and more hits, because the album is big, man.
Yeah.
It just sounds big. It's like, it's gonna paralyze the game, man.
I can't wait to hear it, man.
And of course, you know, I want to make sure we shout out all the beautiful bartenders, waitresses, and dancers in all the strip clubs in Philadelphia. We appreciate you.
Yes.
And you know what I'm saying?
I got that serious strip club.
Oh, yeah, they got them.
Yeah, they got them.
And the next time we roll through the city.
Yeah, we was in Onyx last night.
Onyx, the one, huh?
What they was doing.
That's what I'm saying. I debuted that Pick It Up last night in Onyx.
Amber Rose used to work in that one?
Nah, she used to work at this one called Delilah's.
Nice.
Delilah's, yeah, Delilah's. I've been to Delilah's. But nice. That's when AI used to play here. I used to go to Delilah's.
Yeah, they was in there. But at Onyx, last night they was in there, and they gave a good reaction when I played that pickup.
Man, we should have came here last.
You should have. Man, well, I'm back in there. If y'all come on a Saturday, pull up on me.
You'll be up there
on Saturdays? I'll be on in there Saturday, every Saturday.
We're going
to have to make a Pick It Up movie.
Yeah.
Nah, the Pick It Up Philly version coming, you know?
See you up in Onyx on Saturday.
That's
yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
I might have to get my verse to chill crack.
I like that.
And I am telling you. Y'all bugging out.
Right? I appreciate y'all, brothers. Go ahead and tell them your Instagram handles and your social media, man.
Yeah, I'm Fat Joe on Instagram, Fat Joe on Twitter, Fat Joe on Facebook.
Mine is real simple. Dreday3000 on Instagram. Dreday3000. Get at me, please.
Word. Yeah.